Hey everyone, welcome back to the Encrypted Capital Recap for Friday, March 26th. We took the last week off because we were putting out videos constantly and we need a little bit of a break. We enjoyed some of our Dent profits and now we're coming back feeling strong. So first off, I did want to mention our Encrypted Capital newsletter. We did mention Dent March 18th, that it was teasing resistance. You can see here, it was at 0039 cents. And that move, had you got out at the top of this move, it would have netted you a cool 300%. So sign up for the newsletter. It's free. If you guys want to support the channel, we do have a paid version, which delivers way more content than we give our free subscribers. So go ahead, check that out. And then last but not least, we got our Encrypted Capital Instagram. You guys definitely need to check that out. We got some really cool content on there talking about that relist XRP, getting that trending on Twitter. No one's putting out content like this that I've seen. I think we got some really good stuff for you guys. So please go ahead, give us a follow. We'd really appreciate it. Right now, we're just sitting at 147 followers. And so let's get right into it. First up, I got Electroneum. I mentioned this a couple weeks ago when we were talking about rebalancing portfolios and suppressed assets on this channel. And Electroneum is making its move today, or so it appears. It's teasing resistance. I just sent that out to the paid members. By the time you guys see this, it'll be a couple hours later, but it's up about 18% for the day right now, and it's been on an absolute tear. And so I kind of wanted to get into Electroneum a little bit and kind of where it's been, where it's going. I mean, these gains have been absolutely insane if you're riding from the bottom. Let's go ahead and see here. We did not get in to this at the very bottom, but we were fairly close. And so you're looking at 690%, and that, in my opinion, still has a lot of room left to grow. Let's talk about Electroneum real quick. We'll get into Richard L's LinkedIn profile real quick. This is the creator of Electroneum, and he's got some past experience. He's ran a couple companies and whatnot, and he basically utilized this Retortle and used that to build his cryptocurrency. And so I want to get into Electroneum because this kind of goes in line with the telecom providers and how they're trying to let the unbanked people be able to send money back and forth easily via their mobile phones. And so, you know, in this whole, I guess, group of cryptocurrencies where you got Electroneum, you got Telcoin, you have Dent, all these guys are basically in the mobile telecom space. And I think this is a very important space to be in for cryptocurrencies, because if these guys are utilizing the telecom providers to basically bypass KYC, like we know that Dent is doing, or I should say that we know that Telcoin is doing. Dent, they've already built their marketplace in order to be able to transact your basically unused mobile data. But Electroneum is one of those ones that I want to throw into the mix because it's been making a really nice move. And I want to go into how their journey began. It says that Richard L started his interest in cryptocurrency back in 2015, where he was building GPU mining rigs. And by 2016, and even back then when Bitcoin was worth just a mere $500, Richard knew blockchain technology would change the world for the better. It says when friends and family would visit, they couldn't understand the complexity of cryptocurrency, and Richard wanted to make it easier for people to use so they too could benefit from the transformational nature of blockchain technology. And so the fun fact with this was that, you know, Electroneum was a ICO essentially. And the token sale was a great success because it had the most participant by numbers, so 115,000 plus. And then the value of the Bitcoin and Ethereum that was used to purchase Electroneum at that time was $40 million. And so these guys have been around for a little while. And I think, like I said, I think they're tackling a really good use case, similar to their counterparts of Telcoin and Dent. And so we'll tap into their website here talking about the benefits for people. Electroneum is a cryptocurrency that people can not only use to buy everyday essential items either in store or online, but also earn more via our online freelance marketplace, anytask.com. And so that's their other company. Here are just some of the ways people are using ETN today. It says mobile airtime and data top up, prepaid electricity meter top up, everyday essentials like food and water, tax rights to local market towns, and much more. And so they definitely have been, you know, like I said, in the game for a while. And I think that their price increase is probably just due to the space that they're in. And on top of that, you know, getting more and more people aware of what the product is and what they're actually trying to solve here. So similar to like that Dent Wireless, where we're talking like about the mobile airtime and data top up, and Dent basically being used to basically let their customers sell their unused mobile data. And here we have that marketplace for telco and digital assets. So, you know, these guys have seen crazy, crazy price gains in the last few months. We're talking about Telcoin, Dent, and Electroneum. All of them are up massively. Telcoin being the one that's up the most. I think at its all-time high, it was up 78x your money. And let's see where Dent is right now. So Dent, from where it started all the way down here, we'll go ahead and take a look here. So Dent right now is up 5,350% at its top. Obviously, it's right now it's up a little bit less than that, 4,000%. But yeah, so 53 times your money. So it's still a trailing behind Telcoin. And so in my opinion, you know, we had Telcoin essentially, we'll pull up Tel, it reached its almost its all-time high of one penny just underneath there. And so now if we were to go over to Dent, Dent still has a lot of room to grow simply for the fact that its all-time high was 11 cents. And so can we continue to get an insane move out of here? This chart's not showing it. It looks like HitBTC doesn't have that much data back there, but it is 11 cents. That is the all-time high. So to go from here, you still have 11x your money. So I think Dent is still really a great project. And in my opinion, it's still very undervalued. And some of the rumors that they've been talking about working with Elon Musk and Starlink and all that stuff, I don't know if that's true or not. It does seem like they released that on Twitter, kind of stating that they were getting some equipment from them and that they were going to maybe being able to try and use whatever they ordered from them in conjunction with their product. I guess that has yet to be seen, but you're still talking 11x, it's all-time high. So I still think it's a great coin token to get into. And what else do we got here today? Went through the Dent team. Oh yeah, so the one thing I wanted to point out from Dent though, so this gentleman right here, when we go to the team, Taro Katajanen, I'm probably saying that wrong. It says he holds a Master of Science in Electrical Engineering from University of Tampere, Finland. His deep knowledge on complicated commerce systems is a big advantage for Dent. Taro was also one of the first developers ever to implement direct mobile operator payment systems to consumer applications. As a specialist for large transactional systems, Taro is the mastermind of all tech at Dent. And so we went ahead and pulled up his LinkedIn profile here. And I found a couple interesting things. But the main thing that I found that was the most interesting to me was when I was going back and looking at where he previously worked. And this right here, United Nations, ESCAP. That is a huge, huge benefit when you have somebody like that on your team who has worked for the United Nations. Not only that, but he's also been a Java and Mobile Systems Development Associate. And so I know a lot of the stuff that he's done prior to this ties into what he's doing now. And with these people that he's worked with at the United Nations, you know, when I'm betting on cryptocurrencies, a lot of the time I am betting on the people that are running it and the connections that they have. This is why, even though I'm not invested in Polkadot, I think Polkadot's really good because you have the gentleman who is the CEO of that. I forget his name off the top of my head, but that gentleman was part of the Thiel Fellowship, which means that he has direct ties to Peter Thiel. And we all know Peter Thiel is one of the, number one, he's a billionaire and he's a founder of PayPal. And so when I see those types of connections to some of these cryptocurrencies, it's very hard for me to believe that those cryptocurrencies will not succeed. I feel like they will do everything they can to make it succeed. And so will all their billionaire friends, because guess what? You know, they're gonna help their friends out in hopes of getting helped out in return. So when I see those types of partnerships and those types of people that have worked for government agencies similar to David Schwartz with the NSA, you know, David Schwartz, the CTO of Ripple, XRP, all those connections, when I see those, I am chomping at the bit, because I know that those probably are not going to go anywhere anytime soon. You know, even like Jed McCaleb, you have him starting Mt. Gox, then going into Ripple Labs, and then going and starting Stellar. You know, he's involved in basically three of the biggest cryptocurrency companies to ever exist. So wherever that guy goes, guess what? I will probably end up putting my money on him. So I think that that's what you guys should do too. If you guys want some of that info, some of the research and data that we find when we go and do these deep dives on some of these projects, subscribe to the newsletter, get that paid version, because that's where we release our research and those upcoming sleeper coins that no one's talking about. I think that is very, very crucial to making smart investments. So definitely do that. And speaking of Peter Thiel and bringing up Tesla, Elon Musk, and all those guys, you know, there's this article that came out about Tesla accepting Bitcoin, you can buy for it, and or buy with it. And it says if you accidentally overpay, Tesla won't reimburse you. Go figure. But that's not what I want to talk about. This was what I want to talk about right here, was this episode with Anthony Pompliano here. His wife, Paulina, I believe her name is, asked a really great question when they started getting into this Tesla information. And I wanted to point this out here because his answer was just so, I don't know. Let me play it for you guys. We'll see. And then we'll talk about it in a sec here.
But now Elon Musk is saying that you can buy Teslas and it is using internal and open source software.
So the biggest deal here is not that you can pay for a Tesla with Bitcoin. It's that Tesla is not going to convert. No, they're not going to convert the Bitcoin to dollars.
Right. So
they're going to hold the Bitcoin. He's trying to acquire as much Bitcoin as possible. You want to give him a Bitcoin? Great. He'll take it. He'll give you a
car. Can I ask a dumb question?
Yeah.
Why did it take Elon so long? What happened?
Well, he's a little busy. You know, he's creating reusable rockets, landing them on drone ships.
Bitcoin is right up his alley. He's about to start PayPal. Like, how can you not see this?
There's many people who have started payment companies. Some of his colleagues have been into Bitcoin for a while. So, look, he's there.
That's what I'm saying.
No problem. It's all good. The second thing is that they're actually running nodes.
All right. Did you see how he answered that question? Like, she asked a great question. Why did it take Elon Musk so long to get into Bitcoin when he started PayPal and this is right up his alley? And Pomp says, oh, he was busy. He's been busy launching rockets, man. He sounds like a total idiot. Either, like, it's so easy for me to see through. And my contrarians, you guys know this stuff. You think Elon Musk just now at 50K got into Bitcoin? Like, come on. He's been here for a very, very long time. And as I've said a million times beforehand, they're only going to start talking about it on mainstream media when they are ready to start selling to you. And even this guy, I think one of the other guys I follow brought this up in one of his videos. When Jim Cramer was talking about how he sold his initial investment in Bitcoin, took profits, and then he's looking for the next best thing. Look for them to start floating out information and stories about Ethereum now as they start to run up the price of Ethereum, and they will all be getting out of their positions when that hits. And then when I start seeing them do what they did with like a Brian Kelly and XRP and showing everybody how to buy XRP, you can bet your ass I will for sure be exiting my positions when they come back on CNBC and start showing people how to buy XRP. Those are the telltale signs that you are at the top. So please keep that in mind, my contrarians. You guys already know the stuff, but if you guys are new to the space, definitely do not trust stuff that these guys are saying, like, oh, he's been busy landing rockets. He didn't think to get into Bitcoin. But yet Peter Thiel is like behind Polkadot, like one of his boys. Like, come on. Like, use your brain. If you're new to the space, use your brain. Contrarians, you guys know this stuff already. I'm going to get out of here. It's going to be back. Sorry if that was a little bit of a rough one. I was a little rusty. If you guys want, please subscribe to the newsletter. It's free. And if you want to support the channel, we got the paid version too. And with that being said, please drop a like, comment below. Tell me what you think of Anthony Pompliano. I would love to hear your guys' opinions. And with that being said, we will catch you all in the next video.